In this video, I'll be talking about the Teppo. It's an obsolete gun with a fuse cord and called as a matchlock in English. A ship drifted ashore at Tanegashima Island in the southwestern part of Japan in 1543 in the middle of the Warring States period in Japan. There were two Portuguese merchants aboard and they had several Teppos with them. They offered two to Tokitaka, the feudal lord or ruler of Tanegashima Island. Tokitaka gave one to Kinbei, who was a craftsman, and ordered him to reproduce more of it. Kinbei dismantled it to learn its structure and system and succeeded in manufacturing dozens of it by himself in the end. Merchants from several cities in Japan who heard about that and were eager to forge it went to Tanegashima Island to learn how to produce it. They acquired production techniques, returned to their own cities, and succeeded in mass producing it. Moreover, they made an improvement on the trigger of the Teppo with making use of a spring, which could result in a high accuracy of a hit. Japan was in the middle of Warring States period and the daimyos, the feudal lords, competed to purchase Teppos. Especially Nobunaga, one of the daimyos, purchased 3,000 Teppos and won the Nagashino battle with Katsuyori cavalry. Please watch my other video about Nagashino battle for more details. Although there are no statistical data, it's said that there were more than 500,000 Teppos in Japan. A missionary from the Society of Jesus reported to Itari, his home country, that he was surprised at the huge number of Teppos in Japan. They played a big role to move strongly forward Nobunaga's campaign to unify Japan and end the Warring States period. In other words, if there were no Teppos in Japan, it would last another 100 years.